I mean, let's just stay candid for a second. You've got to regret ordering a $16 orange juice, no?
Not at all, not at all. I have been working hard. I arrived in London, was very late. I was working on a speech I was to give the next morning. But you know, that cost of the orange juice was not maybe the appropriate expense for the government to pay. I've repaid that cost and I have apologized for it. Evan and I would hope that, you know, we can all move on, I can move on, be proud of the work that I've done, to have Canadians be proud of Canada's position in helping the world's most vulnerable people. And
that's the problem in politics. Does it overshadow the legacy? I mean, you did all that work. You're a minister for CETA. And then at the end of your career, and again, we've spoken a lot, people are talking about limousines, $16 orange juice in the Savoy Hotel. I mean, I guess my question is, did you end up stepping on the legacy of your own career?
Evan, at the end of the day, you know that legacies take many, many years to formulate and for people to do an assessment with some distance. I would say to you that not everyone, because I know that I'm receiving many well wishes. I'm meeting my constituents who understand that a lot of the discussion over the past months hasn't been about the substance of the real work that they want all their members of parliament to do in Ottawa. And so consequently, I can hold my head up proudly. I'm proud to be a part of, to have been a part of the government. I'm proud to have represented the people of my riding honorably and also brought some good things to the riding.